Hello. Good morning. Absolutely an earnest apology for starting late. There is a little Bombay traffic bout which we undereducated Delhi people do not know about. And we completely miscalculated the time and got stuck in the road. Absolutely, we're terribly sorry for this. But a very, very warm welcome, of course, to the third session of our international seminar, Who Shrinks My Theater? And today's subject is focusing on the perspective of the acting from the perspective of the actors. And we are very happy to have with us Mr. Kamalakar Sontake as the chair. And Mr. Sontake, born in the village of Wadur Chata in Aurangabad district of Maharashtra, is a well-known director and actor in the Hindi and Marathi theatre. He is also known as an art administrator. He holds a master's degree in Hindi from the Dr. Babasaheb Marathwada University, Aurangabad, and was trained in theatre at the National School of Drama, New Delhi, where he took his diploma in 1966. His teachers at NSD were eminent figures in theatre, such as Ibrahim Alkazi, Nimichandra Jain, Sheila Bhatia, Govardhan Panchal, and Panchanan Pathak. Sri Sontake taught speech, acting, and production at the school from 1966 to 1968. Subsequently, he established the Department of Theatre at Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University and headed the department from 1972 to 1978. In later years, he has served as director of the South Central Zone Cultural Center, Nagpur, 1986 to 91, and has headed the Nehru Center in Mumbai, 1992 to 1999. Sri Sontake has directed over 40 plays in Hindi, Marathi, English, and Gujarati. He has acted in more than 20 plays. He has translated a number of classic and contemporary plays in various languages into Hindi, such as Vishakhadatta's Mudra Rakshasa, Vasa's Madhyam Vyaga, Tendulkar's Khamosh Adalat Chalu Ahe, Siti Khanulkar's Ek Shunya Bajirao, G. Shankara Pillai's Sharashavan, Madhukar Torarmal's Kishandeep, and Mahesh Elkunchwar's Sultan. He has written on theatre in Hindi and Marathi periodicals and has presented papers at seminars on the performing arts. Sri Sontake has been actively involved in organising major festivals of arts such as Apna Utsav in Delhi 1986 and Mumbai 1989. He has also been associated with international events organised by the Government of India in France, Mauritius, Japan and the United Kingdom. He has an advisor to several institutions in planning and building theatres and arts. Arts complexes. For his services in to theatre, Sri Sontake has been confirmed the Kala Gaurav Puraskar 2003 of the Government of Maharashtra. Sri Kamalakar Sontake receives the Sangeet Natak Academy Award for his contribution to Indian theatre as a director. We have with us as speakers none other than Miss Iliana Sitaristi. Miss Iliana Sitaristi is an Italian-born Odissi and Chow dancer and dance instructor based in Bhubaneswar, India. She was awarded the 43rd National Film Awards for the Best Choreography for Yuganti in 1995 and became in 2006 the first dancer of foreign origin to be conferred the Padma Shri for her contributions in Odissi. Sitaristi studied Odissi under Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra and started her own school of dance in 1994. Sitaristi is also an exponent of the Mayurbhanj Chow, which she learnt under the tutelage of Guru Hari Nayak, and holds the title of an Acharya of Chow from the Sangeet Mahavidyalaya Bhubaneswar. She founded the Art Vision Academy in 1996, which acts as a platform for sharing ideas between various artistic forms such as theatre, music, dance and painting. The Academy also conducts classes in Odissi and Chow. A very, very warm welcome to Miss Iliana Sitaristi. And we also have with us one of the doyen of theatre, Miss Neena Kulkarni. She is an Indian actress, model, column writer, producer and director. She began her acting career in the 1970s on Marathi professional stage and Hindi experimental stage, along with fashion shows and modeling simultaneously. She met Pandit Satyadev Dubey, her first guru, and went on to be a part of several Hindi productions under his direction. Mohan Rakesh's Adhe Adhure, Shankar Shesh's Mayavi Sarovar, Willie Russell's Educating Rita are a few of her prominent plays. Dr. Vijay Mehta chose her to play Shabbo in Anil Varve's Hamida Bai Ki Chi Kothi in 1978 and thus began her long journey with Bai into the remarkable world of Marathi theatre with Mahasagar and Savitri. She continues to assist Bai in her workshops. Mahasagar, Akasmat, Dhyani Mani, Vadvat Savitri, Dehavan Prem Patra, Hamida Bai Chi Kothi, Chapa Kata are some more of her successful award-winning Natya Darpan State Awards, Natya Parishad Recognition Marathi plays. Directed the play Mahasagar in 2011, Mahatma vs. Gandhi, Wedding Album English plays. Her prominent Marathi films are Savat Mazi Ladki, State Award Best Actress, I, Uttarayan, Shavri, for which she won the National Award and PIFF Award as producer, Sari vs. Sari, State Award Best Supporting, Bioscope, Filmfare Best Supporting. Her latest television show Ye Hai Mohabbate, running its fourth year. International projects, The Best Exotic Marigold Hotel, Rani, in 8-part series in the French language, telecast on Channel France 2. We also have with us Mr. Milind Malse, who is... I'm so sorry. I'm terribly sorry. Mr. Milind Shinde. And of course, he doesn't need any introduction, particularly to this city. No, but for the occasion, I would say a few words about him. He acted in one of his early work, was performing in Zulva with Mr. Vaman Kendre, which had absolutely shot him to fame and attention. And he is a regular actor of many, many Marathi theatre pieces and television and films. And he has won several state and national awards. And a very warm welcome to all these people. Now I request the chair and the other three speakers to kindly come up onto the stage. And if I may request Professor Shafat Khan to kindly come up and offer flowers to our distinguished speakers. I'm so sorry for that. Thank you so much, Professor Khan. And now we start our session. I would request our chair to start the presiding. Thank you.
Thank you, Shantanu. And I'm happy to have a few new faces today in the auditorium. Welcome to them also. Friends, yesterday it was the first day of the seminar, and when Shantanu introduces people, it's a matter of great pride. Lagta hai ki aapko ek naye se apna hi parichay mil raha ho. So Shantanu, thankful to your good words. Yesterday, we followed a pattern in the seminar that each of the artists presented his views, and we didn't had scope for interaction for two reasons, because the views expressed by the experts, the viewers and the audience members were not probably equipped to go with them because of the foreign experience on one hand, and even a different point of view of the speaker. But in case we have time, we'll definitely have a couple of questions. I'll not take your time. सवाल वही है मेरा थिएटर क्यों सिकुड़ रहा है कौन उसके लिए आघात कर रहा है आई विल लीव इट टू माय स्पीकर्स एंड विल स्टार्ट विद बघूया ना भाऊ काय होतंय ते. मिलिंद शिंदे प्लीज.
थँक्यू सर. ऑल ग्रेट पर्सनॅलिटीज ऑन द डायस. कमलाकरजी सोनटक्के, इलियानाजी अँड ग्रेट ॲक्ट्रेस नीनाजी कुलकर्णी अँड माय फ्रेंड यशराज, हू आर समहाउ मेंटर ऑफ माइंड, बिकॉज विदाउट हिम इट इज बीन पॉसिबल टू बी हियर, बिकॉज इट वॉज अहमदनगर अँड आय वॉज इट्स वॉल स्मॉल सिटी अँड ही टॉट मी अँड ही शोड मी द वे to the drama school, and so that will lead to this stage. I'm really thankful to him. Coming to the point, I came to this city like 18, 20 years back, when I recently passed out from National School of Drama. Even that time also, there was thinking, there was a thought in the city that there is no theater exists apart from Mumbai. There are no actors exists apart from Mumbai. It was quite obvious that there is no training, no reach, no activities there. But I came here, I passed out School of Drama, then I went to FTII. I landed here with a big dilemma, what to do, how to approach, how to go forward. In spite of passing of National School of Drama, I used to see myself where I stand in the city as far as an actor, me actor being concerned. I used to see myself a peon, a security guard, a postmaster. So I think it's difficult to proceed with this much of my attitude towards my acting career. That swinged me somehow. How to proceed? From this with a colorful city, it is very difficult to go with non-branded clothes, non-branded shoes, and non-branded attitudes. So what I thought is, I'll search playwright who will write for me, write such characters which I can perform. But all went in vain. So I collected some like-minded friends, and with them I used to search for the writers who write characters for me, or they will write characters for me, so I want to do a theater. So me and my friends used to go and visit playwrights, and we used to tell them that this is what I want to do, this kind of theater I want to do. I'm from National School of Drama, I'm from FTI, I'm an aspiring actor, I want to be an actor. So they have some stock of plays, they used to give it to me. And obviously, I was not satisfied with it. But after a few days of struggle, being an actor, I thought, why not? I will write a play then. Wow. I will not wait for somebody to write for me, and then I will perform and I will get an opportunity to act on the stage. So I wrote a play. Yeah, it went well. But what shrinks my theater is my bridge to playwright, my bridge to writer, my approach to writer. Rather, I couldn't communicate, rather I'm still communicating it, and I think one day I'll get success into it. Subsequently, I'm still in search of good play. I don't want to shrink my theater activities at all. So I want to explore myself more than enough. I want to stretch myself out of my capacity. I want to build the wall and break them on myself only. Secondly, what shrinks my theater is, I came from a small city called Ahmednagar. After passing out from National School of Drama, my school wants me to go to my native place and work there. I went there. As Yashraj told me, go to drama school. Now I go to the people, go to new students and ask them, I think you can do something in this acting area, please do join National School of Drama. In reply, what I got is, I will go to Mumbai rather than spending 3 years in National School of Drama. Somehow I failed to like encourage them somehow. I have failed to tell them that this education is very important. I think I have to go there, work a lot there. I want to remove this thought from them that education matters a lot. But I know. Now every city has a theater. Every city has these filmmakers with the camera 5D and all. And they are making films. They are making short films. And they are taking actors from the very city only. Now everybody is actor now. They are acting TV serials. The TV serials are being shoot. They are happening in the very city only. So they think like, why to go to National School of Drama and then go to FTIR to get acting training? I am here acting with you without any training. So I think when I want to do a theater, I haven't created atmosphere in my city to think actor training is important. I think all blame I take on me rather than blaming others. I think I couldn't make the bridge with the playwright. Similarly, I couldn't make the bridge with aspiring actors to get trained themselves. And thirdly, I think being the School of Drama passed out, I feel I'm a responsible citizen. And I always feel that I have some responsibility. There is a poem I'll tell you, most probably it will hit you in Hindi. दंगल हुई शहर में दंगल हुई गुनहगार पकड़ने का आदेश निकला एक के बाद एक गुनहगार पकड़े गए न्यायाधीश के सामने खड़े कर दिए गए न्यायाधीश ने पूछा कौन कौन है इसमें से जिम्मेदार कौन कौन है इसमें से गुनहगार एक एक करके आरोपी आते रहे न्यायाधीश महोदय बोलते रहे कि बताओ इन्होंने क्या किया है तुमने बोला ये है एक दल का कार्यकर्ता है ये दंगल भड़काता है अच्छा इसे दो कोड़े मारो और छोड़ दो है कोई और आरोपी है और है ये कौन है ये उस दल का प्रमुख है ये बहुत सारी बातें करता है और दंगल भड़काता है न्यायाधीश महोदय बोले अच्छा ऐसा है इसको सात कोड़े मारो और छोड़ दो और कोई है यस देयर इज वन मोर इज स्पोक्स पर्सन ऑफ दैट दल दैट पार्टी He speaks. अच्छा इसके वजह से दंगल भड़कती है इसको 15 कोड़े मारो और छोड़ दो न्यायाधीश महोदय बोले और कोई है वकील साहब बोले हैं और एक है हो ऐसी एक अदनास आदमी सामने आके खड़ा हुआ न्यायाधीश महोदय बोले क्या करते हो आप वकील से पूछा क्या है कौन है ये वो बोले कि ये कलाकार है न्यायाधीश महोदय ने उसको देखा ऊपर से नीचे तक कलाकार है इसको 5000 कोड़े मारूं इस शहर में यह है और दंगल भड़कती कैसे सो आई फील वेरी रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दिस स्टेज फॉर दिस कंट्री फॉर दिस ह्यूमैनिटी थैंक यू वेरी मच एवरीबॉडी थैंक्स अ लॉट
थैंक यू मिलिन देखा धरती से जुड़ा हुआ आदमी अपने अनुभवों से सीढ़ी तर सीढ़ी कहाँ पहुँच जाता है और जो विषय है उसके मूल में जाकर बहुत लौकिक अर्थ से उसको दर्शकों तक पहुँचाता है रियली रियली वेरी हैप्पी मिलिन मिलिन के लिए मैं हमेशा कहता रहता हूँ कि इसे लेकर शेक्सपियरियन ट्रेजेडी खेली जाए इसे लेकर इवन इटालियन कॉमेडी खेली जाए इस आदमी की टाइमिंग का सेंस जो देखा है वामन भैया के नाटक में टी फुल रानी में आज तक लोग याद करते हैं वेरी वेरी हैप्पी मिलिन नाउ इलियाना शी हैज़ बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड टू यू बट टू मी एज अ थिएटर पर्सन शी इज़ वन ऑफ द आइडियल्स इन द फील्ड ऑफ performing arts and classical arts. Her experience is very vast. She has worked with people at the downtrodden stage to the masters in the country. Iliana, we invite you, please.
Thank you. Namaskar. I'm very happy to be here and very honored. Actually, I thought maybe my experience of coming from Italy, where I was engaged in theater, and coming to India when I became a classical dancer. So this journey could be interesting for the topic which we are dealing today. When I was in Italy, I was searching for an expression. So this is the why my search finally brought me to India, for a physical expression, expression through the body. I started in a traditional theater, conventional theater in Italy. It was a professional group, but it was more. When I say conventional, means it's more. It was more based only on verbalization, on acting through words. It didn't have much training behind about body posture, body movement, the presence of the actor on the stage. It what kind of gesticulation? It was more based on text. And although I did a little bit of Commedia dell'arte, and we know that Commedia dell'arte has characterization, has characters which have very much precise way of interpreting, but those are the mask character. But if you are just a normal characters, then again you fall a little bit into this kind of acting in which text is more important. Probably unconsciously, I was searching for something which would involve more the body, and I was not yet clear about what I was searching for. Also, because at that stage of rebellion in the 70s, 80s, which I was belonging to the student revolution, to the feminist movement, so whatever it was that was bringing us outside our house, outside our family, to contact, to become independent, to have an identity which was not the one which was the bourgeois type of identity. So theater was part of that also. But from there, I came to experience a different type of theater, which was the Grotowski, Jerzy Grotowski theater movement, which was it was actually given to us through stage, through workshops. So it, we had the possibility, all of us young people who are searching for some expression, for some theater expression, we were given the chance to attend some of the workshops of the actors of Grotowski, Jerzy Grotowski. And the experience which I went through in the first workshop was incredible. It was just a wild type of energy which we could exercise, and creativeness at the maximum. We were given 15 days, a place where to stay, and whatever idea we had, we could implement it, and we could get whatever props and whatever things we needed to materialize this idea. And it was just creativity and energy as a maximum, without any framework of when to start, when to end. You just collapse at the end of the work, the middle of the night, in the middle of the day, but it was fully a creativeness which was at work. So this was 15 days intensive workshop which I did in Italy with one of the actor of Jerzy Grotowski, was Stanislaw Staszek, was the younger of the group. And from there I had some experience with Eugenio Barba group, which, for example, it was a workshop in which we had to be in a new place, in a small village in Italy, and each of us was supposed to create a character and populate and animate the environment. So it was a street theater which could happen on the road, on the terraces, on the roof. I mean, we were supposed to create a theater in the village. So the entire village was the stage. So that time I remember that I just chose to cover myself with a black cloth and to disappear. I mean, I was not trained yet in any particular form of acrobatic or steel theater or anything. So my presence was a non-presence in the group. So, but that also was an experience. And then I got to have an experience with the Bread and Puppet Theater again through a 3 months workshop in Italy. And there I learned techniques like to make big masks with paper mache and to walk on stilt and to create a character which would again be in the street theater, but it was supposed to be created in 3 months so I decided to be a horse rider and I created my horse and my things and I learned how to go on stilt. So it was the mask of the Bread and Puppet, the characters of the Bread and Puppet theater were very big because we were supposed to be on the road, a street theater, but very much visible. So we had to be very big and attractive. So that was a type of experience again. So after all these experiences, I started to create my own group. But what I learned, especially from the Grotowski technique, was that we would start from improvising with a stimulus, with certain theme, which the leader of the group would give. And all the members would just react to that physically, verbally, whatever they wanted, vocally. The most wild form as possible, in improvising on that, whatever reaction, spontaneous reaction would come from you. And from there, the leader or the director or whatever was supposed to take away layers by layers and trying to give and suggest some other possibility. Again, seeing the second stage, then the third stage. Then again, by cleaning up whatever the improvisation was and start to find something on which starting to work. So from the wildest improvisation comes towards a beginning on which starting to work for that particular character which we want to create. So this was, but how to start, what kind of preparation we had, it was very improvised. And we were trying with different putting hands over the face, shouting loudly, going up on the trees and doing with clothes, without clothes, projecting on. So it was really the starting point was the maximum wild as possible. So at this point, I happened to see one demonstration by a Katakali guru in my own town in Bergamo, in Italy. And I was stuck by this because whatever we were searching for, because we were searching for a grammar which we didn't have, and we were searching for this grammar of the body by starting from all sort of means. At that point, when in front of this demonstration, I realized that this guru was telling that each mudra, each small mudra, each gesture, it was codified. It was a precise grammar that he was presenting, and each movement of each part of the body had a particular purpose, a particular meaning. So I happened to discover that this grammar, which we were searching for, it was very much existing, it was very much codified, and it was possible to learn it. So for me, it was a revelation, and not only for me, I'm sure, but many young people who were searching, and we were at that point of search, like me. I went to him, to this guru, he was Krishnanam Budiri from Kerala, and I told him that it was, for me, it was a revelation, I would like to learn what he was expressing. And he said, yes, I will. I'm going to organize a 3 months workshop in Sri Krishnapuram, and that is 1978. And because I had the same request from many young theater practitioners in this tour, he said. And so on the 1st of April in 1978, I came to India straight to Sri Krishnapuram. and at 10 o'clock sharp, as the starting of the workshop was there. And this was my second trip to India. The first one was as a hippie in 75, so never didn't have anything to do with dance. But this time had a specific purpose to have this experience. And it was an incredible experience for 3 months, intensive training of having a guru, having somebody who would give you exactly what to do. And whatever you were doing, it had a particular meaning, a purpose, and a discipline of the body, which I was searching for, but I didn't know where to find it. So this kind of experience terminated after 3 months with the full performance, with the green patch, because I wanted to experience also the makeup. I wanted to be a male character, because that would give me the possibility to have this full makeup, the white bird here, the green patch, and the big mukuta, and this layers of cloth around me. So, and that was, again, an incredible experience. When they were dressing me up for hours, and when I got up from the entire process of makeup, and I thought that I'll not be able to move. I mean, I was terrified about these meters and meters of cloth and all this big and heavy mukuta. And what saved me at that point, it was that just I look myself in the mirror, and I just did some movement like this. And I understood that actually the makeup was enhancing my movement, was not taking away, not killing my, you know, my. So that inspiration got me safe, and I went into the stage, means that small room full of all the villagers and all these things in the middle of the Kerala summer. And I was saved, because I understood that, in fact, all the movement also of the dance were amplified by this cloth which was putting around me. So that gave me the inspiration, and I performed whatever, the Purappadu and the small Nala Damayanti, small piece of Abhinaya. And at the end of this cathartic experience, where for the first time, whatever I had heard about the theory of the acting and actor, which is becoming the person who disappear into the acting, and the cathartic experience of transforming yourself into somebody else. So all these theoretic things, actually, I experienced for a few seconds, a few minutes. I realized that the people were seeing me as that particular character, because also of all this makeup and this transformation, physical transformation, in which my identity, also physical identity, was not more visible. I was no more with my features. It was, and the people were seeing me as what I was representing. So it was a really cathartic experience, which left me totally. I couldn't just think that I would go back to Italy as if nothing had happened. Something very, very, very strong happened. Very, very, very strong experience. So I just, of course, after finishing the performance, if they were not removing my mukuta, I would have fainted, because really it was really heavy, heavy. But I just told Krishna Nambudiri, what else now? I mean, I can't go back like this. Something happened, and I just can't think that it is just a normal. So he told me, oh, there is another beauty, because the workshop was over. The entire group of Kathakali actors were going in tour. So there is another beautiful style, which is Odissi dance, and he had met Sanjukta Panigrahi abroad. So at that point, he could have told me anything. I mean, if he was telling me to go to the moon, I would have gone to the moon. For me, Odyssey or any other, it was totally, I didn't know anything about anything else. I had only this experience of Kathakali with me, which was something which transformed totally my. So I crossed the country and go as I was with my dhoti, longi folded up in the Kerala style. I went to Sanjukta Panigrahi's address, and I just said I've done this and this experience. So I just stayed for a couple of months there. And I went back to, I learned a little bit of Odissi, and naturally the feet which were putting on the side, been put on the side like this, became had to be put in this way, in the Odissi style. And so it was totally another kind of, but again, a technique, again, a grammar, again, something which we had, you had something to be taught, to follow. And I went back and I thought that, okay, I can put up my play now by utilizing some of these movements. So it was still theater which had brought me here to India. And I still thought that I could adopt this movement into something which is, it was with text, but utilizing all these different experience with which I had before also, so projection on shadow projection and some movement of the animals which I learned in Kathakali, but it was still a play. I put up a Greek myth from Metamorphosis, Ovid, which was Cupid and Psyche, one myth. And after 6 months, I thought, okay, now if I want to continue to enrich my theater vocabulary with this kind of forms, I should come for 1 year. I should go back to India for 1 year and learn more. So I thought that I'll be 6 months in Odissi and 6 months in Kerala. So this time I started with Orissa, and again with this in mind, that would be only 6 months and just learning a technique. So this time I... In the meantime, the previous time, I had written down the name of Sanjukta's guru, which was very long to pronounce for me, Guru Kelucharan Mohapatra, really impossible to pronounce. And in my style, as if I never plan anything, so I just reached the bus stand in Cuttack and I asked to the rickshawwala, this gentleman, I want to go to this person. So he just brought me like this to his house without any introduction or anything. And I was, of course, very wild and with the sleeveless top and rainbow type of skirt and very curling and open air. And so Guruji, very, he accepted me because he was already a little bit exposed to the world, whereas the rest of his family got a little bit scandalized by my appearance. But so I started with him. And what happened, for 6 years, I never went back to Italy. Everything disappeared. Theater, Kerala, Italy, and just destination was that gully, that lane, which was bringing to Guruji's house every day, not missing a single moment of his teaching. So, in the meantime, I came to happen to see the Chao classes also, and I was very fascinated because it was a full body movement, while the Odissi was, of course, involved the entire body, but with stress more on the footwork, on the hand gesture, on the facial expression. When I saw one Chao class in movement, one student in movement, I realized that that kind of full body expression, which I was searching also during my theater experience, was there in the Chao dance. And it happened that it was again from Orissa. So the two things became complementary to each other. The full body expression of the Chao, which is more masculine, more energetic, more with a certain kind of energy that you can say more masculine energy, and the more control and more feminine Odissi, became something which could complement each other and fulfill probably both my masculine and feminine type of need of expression. So what is the important things is this, that I suppose that at a certain point when we were starting in the West from improvisation, free improvisation, and trying to go to a codified type of expression, here we were starting from the opposite, a totally conventional codified language, which we had to go through imitation, through continuous practice, sometimes mechanical repetition and practice, to be able to become spontaneous with it. So the spontaneity had to be reached at the end of the process. Instead that in the Western training which I had gone through. It was starting from the beginning. This one, the process was a sort of reversed, because in the classical dance, we are expected to achieve is that we are acting, we are portraying as if it is absolutely a spontaneous, natural type of, it is so much imbibed in our body that becomes a natural portrayal, but it has gone through years and years of codified movements which are fixed and are being taught in a certain way, which are very precise and strict. So through this discipline and this years of practice, you have to become spontaneous with a conventional type of language. So, and another thing also is the difference of the role of the director, which was, as I said, in the Grotowski or whatever theater which was happening in the West during those years. The director was just directing in a way, not imposing, but trying to take away all the layers of the edges in your improvisation and guide you towards maybe slightly different diversion, or trying to asking you, if we are not doing this, what you would do in that? And this kind of guide, which would at the end reach a nucleus of things on which started to work. But in the figure of the guru, in the classical dance, the guru is somebody to totally imitate, suppose, and not to be questioned too much. I was one in the class which was questioning actually the most, because all the other Indian and Oriya girls, they were just happy to copy and to do what they have been told. I wanted to know why this, what means, what this, what that. So sometimes it was also irritating him. But most of the time, because Guruji was actually the creator of what he was teaching, he would also reply. And that was what brought me to continue and not to reach at the end of this process anytime. And then also realizing that it was not a technique which I was going to take away, as I thought in the beginning when I came, but it was entire cultural context which was involved, and it was and continuously reminding me to another meaning, and this to another one. So to understand the particular gestures, I had to understand the meaning and the place of this gesture inside in a context, in the ritualistic context, in the mythological context, in the historical context. So it was a full culture through the dance vocabulary, through the vocabulary of, it was all the entire culture which was opening to me. So you are opening every time a new door and going deep and deep and deep in it. So, and this is why the entire things capture me. It was like a net around me that which didn't let me leave anymore. So for which I'm still there. I mean, since 79, I'm still over there, very much in Orissa. So I would like just to conclude saying that finally, the purpose for which I came in 79, which was with another Greek meet, when I still thought that I would go back after 1 year and compose this meet in a theatrical form. It was a meet of Eco and Narcissus, again from the Ovid Metamorphoses. I had come with my small bag very lightly, because in any case I thought I would not put roots anywhere. That was our mentality at that time. So it was with this big book of Ovid and this Eco and Narcissus. It was supposed to be put up as a play after 1 year of experience, as I thought, 6 months here and 6 months in Kerala. And this meet eventually, when the East-West dance encounter happened, not after 1 year, but after 6 years of my staying here, when I had acquired the technique of the Chow dance, and I had been asked by the Georg Lechner, who was the organizer of the East-West dance encounter in 1985, here in the Max Müller in Bombay, I've been asked to compose something new, creative, not something which was handed over to me by the gurus. So this technique, the Chow technique, this meet And my past of being philosophical, psychoanalytical, all this, my past studies and all these things came together and created this synthesis in which I could produce something, create something new with the new technique which I learned, with my past experience and my new content which I had acquired in India. And it became my first innovative choreography of Ico and Narcissus in Chao dance, with an electronic music, with the Chao movement which I could expand. And so this synthesis happened, and probably the two things which had kept separately in my previous avatar, as I call it, before coming to India, the philosophical search and the theater and the physical expression, which were parallel because one I was pursuing through the philosophical studies and one through the theater, these two things could get together in a synthesis, and this is what it worked, and that's why probably I found what I was searching for here in India with my classical training. Thank you.
Friends, it was such an interesting journey with Ileana that everybody probably would dream to follow that path, right from the improvisational theater to the theater of mass, Grotowski to Italian approach to theater, to Nambudri's Kathakali. And therein she finds that almost a neo-avatara apna unko de. मिला खुद को ही देखने को मिला फ्रॉम देयर टू ओडिसी विद इंद्रानी रहमान द ग्रेट ग्रेट डांसर इंडिया हैज सीन एंड देयर आफ्टर टू गुरु केलुचरण महापात्रा आई वाज रिमाइंडेड ऑफ केलुचरण महापात्रा द वे शी वाज इनएक्टिंग रादर द जेस्चर द पॉस्चर द बॉडी लैंग्वेज एंड व्हाट नॉट ग्रेट सिंपली ग्रेट एक्सपीरियंस And thereafter, to find a language through the grammar of these two major forms to express yourself. And what she very pointedly mentioned, that she didn't only go through the external grammar, but she tried to relate to the culture, to the environment, to the living. And this is what is important. यदि कोई आपके रंगमंच को टोक लगा रहा है तो मुझे लगता है कि ये अड़ंगे हैं वो मानसिक भी हो सकते हैं दे कैन बी फिजिकल दे कैन बी मेंटल ब्लॉक्स एंड ऑल्सो द ब्लॉक्स विच आर देयर इन द कम्युनिकेशन फ्रॉम सोसाइटी टू द एक्टर और क्रिएटर एंड विस आ विस रियली थैंक यू एंड आई सॉ इलियाना एंड देर इज हार्डली एनी चेंज इन पर्सनैलिटी in her approach and in her enthusiasm to get grab of the subject and leaving. Thank you very much, ma'am. Neena ji, aapko vinti hai. Kindly present your views. Thank you very much.
Hello, friends. Sundaki sir. Firstly, I have to thank National School of Drama for inviting me into Theatre Olympics. I'm not from NSD, and it's always been a kind of a lack of self-confidence because I'm not a student of acting. I've learned it hands-on from my gurus, Satyadev Dubey and Vijaya Mehta. I was, you know, like in the process, and that's how I learned it. So there's always a slight hesitation to come and talk about a thing that I still do after all these years. And I love doing it, and I'm still trying to be the actress that I want to be. And excuse me if I cannot quote, or I'm not academically equipped to do that. You know, I was listening to Ileana, and I felt envious of her, that we, as our culture, we take so much for granted. We all have our journeys, like Milind also said his journey, and now I won't be going through my journey as much. But yes, I have, it is a journey, right, from meeting your gurus and then imbibing what you want. But the way she put it, and the way, I guess, coming from a different upbringing into something which we take so much for granted. And today I was so proud that I'm here and born and brought up. And I will try and be objective, like she was, with the work that I do and not take it so much for granted. Thank you, Elena. Okay, I am going to speak about this subject only. Who shrinks my theatre? Well, as I think of that shrinks my theatre and that, I know that three fingers are pointing to me. And as Milin said, it is within us who shrink ourselves not to do. We don't unleash the giant within us. And that's what happens to us. So as far as theatre is concerned, when I began theatre as a lark, literally. I had no idea what I was doing. I was this happy-go-lucky Elphinstonian who had a flair for languages. And I think that's what got me into theatre and wherever I went. And I was with Panditji for about 7 to 8 years, and I did about 7 to 8 productions with him. And I had my college people with me. That was some Sunil Shanbhag, Ratna Pathak, and husband to be, Dilip Kulkarni, Nasiruddin Shah, who was a friend. And it was just a romp in the fields, literally, you know. I was having fun. Theatre for me was fun. It was something to do. It was an extracurricular activity, which at that point we didn't have too much of. I mean, if you're a sports person, you go and do sports. But for me, it was that. It was just something I went and did compulsively. In Chabeldas, we used to just go and meet over there and then just say lines which we didn't understand head or tail of. Sambhog Se Sanyastak was the first place I did. And I had no idea what I was saying. And thank God for that. There were no audience, one or two people used to come. So that's how I learned that I love to do this and this only. So as time went by, Vijayabai called me for Hamida Vachi Koti because I'd done a workshop with her earlier. And then I met my second guru, and my second foray into theatre was Marathi Professional Theatre, which I have been doing since then, right up to now. As I said, I'm shrinking my own theatre because I don't do as much theatre as I should be doing. I really don't. And I should. And what is it? So this subject made me think about that. I think firstly, it is the times that we lived in. I had gurus and I had directors who were, you know, you could look upon them because they were older than you and you were naive and you didn't understand anything. And they taught you. They were your teachers. It's like school, you know, we still meet our school teachers, we go all wobbly and say, oh my God, still I'm not adequate enough, that kind of stuff. So I come from that theatre where theatre was only theatre. Otherwise, there was films, which was a big no-no. My parents were bad enough, they were very upset that I was doing theatre. So that was bad enough. So me getting into films was out of the question at that point of time. So it was theatre, and theatre is what I kept and kept and kept doing, whether it was experimental, whether it was amateur, whether it was professional. I never ever saw the difference between what I was doing. Okay, Marathi, you go at the end of the thing, you give this thing, funnily it's called night for some reason, I don't know why. So you got money, which is said, Tumchi night. I guess because we had night theatre that time. So that was it, was my pocket money. And then I met my partner who was also, he was a very, very keen theatre person, Dilip Kulkarni. And he, of course, came from experimental theatre and amateur theatre, which he started with his friends in banks. And there was interbank competition. There was a lot happening in theatre that time, of which you choose a certain thing and you go your path. So I feel theatre for an actor is the beginning school. For me, it's school. For my time, people, it's school. Not today anymore, because unfortunately, with a lot of avenues opening in mediums, there are people who first get into the medium and then perhaps go. But I think each and every actor at some point of time has to come home to theatre. You have to, because that is where you learn everything. And I think that what it means for an actor, that you don't really leave it. Like I feel a couple of years ago, I did my last play, which was Chapa Kata. Today, when I don't do it, I say it's my age, which is true also. I'm a senior citizen. And the entire thing of traveling and going from place to place, and though it's easier, you have planes, and you have, but it is tough. It is tough. It takes a toll on you. But more importantly, I feel every time somebody, I get a lot of theatre offers. Every time somebody offers me something, it's a very exciting thing. You know, they tell you on the phone, Neena ji, aisa aisa hai, ya phir aisa aisa hai. And I say, okay, come, narrate to me or let me read the script. And I read the script and something sinks within me. I don't know, I still haven't understood what happens to me, but I think for me, theatre is perfection. You know, it has to reach my heart, it has to reach my head, and then it can come out. Otherwise, I won't sustain it. I come from an age when, if I'm taking up a script, it is the most sacred thing on earth. It is like a prayer book, you know. I have all my scripts with me. It's that reverential for me, honestly. So I think I hesitate to go into theatre full time because I don't want to tamper with it. So it is me who's stopping, but perhaps it's for a good reason. I know that I did Hamida Bai Chikoti, I played Hamida Bai this time 6 years ago. Then 3 years ago, I did Chapa Katta. So I guess my duration of doing a play is perhaps 3 years to 4 years. But I don't think I'll ever stop doing theatre. I read the letter that they'd written to me, in which they'd written it in point forms as to what who shrinks your theatre. So I will be following that up to a point. Theatre today, like, it's very fashionable to say, oh, it's not the same. And, you know, when we were there, it was great. No, I disagree completely. Theatre is so, there's so much happening even in a commercial place like Mumbai. Even in a commercial. There is Sunil Shanbhag doing his own thing somewhere. There is Marathi theatre, which I saw Sangeet Deobabhali the other day. And I was floored. And, you know, on professional stage, when you have something coming up like this, it really makes you proud that, yes, theatre is an activity. Theatre is not something that you go in and earn your money and come out. It's an activity. It's an ongoing activity. And see, after all these years, I keep changing my definition of theatre and what it means to me. I really feel it is an activity, and it is obviously a group activity, or, I mean, you can go solo on stage, but there are 10 people standing behind you to make it possible. And then there are, you know, there is a problem with auditoriums. For me, on a personal level, again, I don't want to get into Marathi professional theatres that easily, because honestly, there are some theatres which repel me. They are not looked after. Perhaps privatization of auditoriums might be the answer to a cleaner environment for actors. I think Milind will agree with me. A lot of actors do feel that way, you know. And then I feel, then why should I do it? Because I carry my theatre in my heart. Honestly, I do films, I do television, I do ads. Everywhere, it's only my theatre that comes in helpful. For me, it is theatre in a different form. It's just another, I mean, that's what I learned, right? The sur, the way I talk, what I project, being very, very observant about the medium that I am acting in, and not being, okay, I'm only going to do this. No, you can't. If you're doing television, you have to learn the sur of that medium. So where did sur come from? It came from theatre. But I learned about pitching, and I learned about Dubeji saying the second half of the sentence stronger than the first, you know. I've learned that from there. So I always come home to theatre. Okay, funding is a thing which I am not really proficient to talk about. But, you know, Marathi theatre fascinates me because the people working in professional Marathi theatre are very, very happy. There's a joy in doing that. The stakes are less, definitely. They multitask because they have the means now. There are more mediums available. But they are very, very happy. Me and my husband started with doing only theatre. Of course, he was doing a bank job for which he was paid pittance. So when we were doing theatre, we were sustained on that till we had our children, stuff like that. But I see even today, Marathi professional theatre, the stakes may be small. The tickets are appallingly and ridiculously low for the kind of theatre that is given to the audience. I mean, 300 rupees, while you go and pay about 2,000 rupees for something else. I feel bad about it. I'm sorry if I'm being very, very open about this. But yes, I keep feeling that these are the things that need to change in funding. Charge higher. Because you know you're giving something very, very good. So if you charge higher, your auditoriums will also be, you'll demand for a better, you know. See, the acoustics, now we have your own acoustics mostly. Mics have come into, that's a different kind of theatre. Some people don't agree with it. I wouldn't too till I tried it in Chapa Katta. You have to learn new things. And I did it and I practiced it. And I realized there are advantages to it. Like today, I do have a mic when I'm talking. But if I didn't, I would perhaps, you know, project my voice. And that is what you're supposed to do in theatre. So I guess keeping open to what is happening in the newer space and not keeping yourself small is what I think theatre means and should mean to a lot of people today. We have Tamasha Theatre, which Sunil and his team are doing. And I keep talking about Sunil because he's a friend and, you know, we've grown up together in college. So I keep watching his theatre. There's Motley, who's doing a different kind of theatre. There's Rahul Dikuna's Rage. I mean, there is so much happening. Let's not say there is no theatre. It is there. You may not like some, you may not accept some, but it is happening. And then I come back to this great realization that theatre is a young activity where the old people can also come in and participate because they are required as characters, you know. You can't do without a senior citizen around. So I feel it's a young activity, and because it's a young activity, it will always go on. There's always a younger crowd to come in and do theatre. I assist my guru Vijaya Mehta in her acting workshops, and she only takes actors who have already done something. She doesn't start with new people. That's her thing. She says, no, I want people who know the basics of theatre and I will take it from there. And I see the enthusiasm, the creativity level, the imagination in youngsters. When we say that there isn't any imagination, I disagree. The more I work with younger people, the more I understand where they are coming from. You know, and I say, okay, there is hope. There is hope of theatre being alive through it. It will withstand anything. You give 1,000 mediums over here. Theatre doesn't go anywhere. And it will never go. And that's why I feel very placated, because I say, okay, if I can't do something now, I can do it tomorrow. I can do it day after. I can go and do some theatre in Prithvi. I can go and do something with Trishla Patel. I can do it whatever. So the moment you open those avenues, there it is. It's there for you. So, yes, it does irritate me that I take up something. Like I like an idea. And then when it's translated into the play, I'm disappointed. Now this, I've tried to examine, why am I disappointed? See, when I began with Satyadev Dubey, he wrote the plays, he chose the plays, he gave it to us, and we did them. I didn't know who Mohan Rakesh was, but I did it. And then today, for me, doing Mohan Rakesh and Adhya Dure, Dune Binni, in that is a matter of pride for me. But that came later, right, in retrospect. When we were doing it, I had no idea what I was doing. So I think we didn't have to choose the scripts. For me, at least, that is a big this thing. Today, when I have to choose a script, yes, I have... Post Vijayabai's theatre, I have chosen scripts which are interesting for me. Like there's been a Dhyani Mani, there has been a Prem Patra which Vaman Kendre had directed with a very different possibility. The play was the old play, Love Letters, but in Marathi we translated into Prem Patra, and Abhiram Bhadkamkar, again from NSD, had done a very good job with it. And the possibility of theatre over there, which Vaman had directed. So I have done these plays which I have chosen to do. But then why is it that today, or even Chhapa Kata, I must tell you a very interesting thing, if somebody could open out what this dilemma for me is, who shrinks it, you know. When Chhapa Kata came to me, Chhapa Kata is a play written by Irawati Karnik, and it's really a wonderful play. It's about the mother and daughter and the complexities of their relationship. And I had seen the play, obviously, because my friend Mukta Barwe had produced it and my dearest friend Reema had acted in it. And so it was already a set play. So when Reema didn't want to do the play and she left it, my name came up and I spoke to her, and obviously then it was done. Now, I took it with the confidence because I knew what ground I was treading into. I knew the director. I knew, acha, this is the thing. I'm getting into a space which is... comfortable, no, I would say, which is comforting for me. So, you know, I think getting into a space, I've even done plays sometimes which I've said okay to. I must give an example. I don't know, this is going to be recorded, so I'm going to be like blacklisted. But a few years ago, Sai Paranspe was doing Jaswandi again. Now, I love that play. I think it is one of her best written pieces. I had seen the original, and Vijayabai had directed it, Vijaya Mehta, and she had acted in it also along with Vikram Gokhale. And when I was asked for it, I jumped. I jumped at it, you know. And I went there, and within the first 2 days, I realized that I am no longer that. You see, that's a woman in her 40s, and perhaps I was asked when I was in my 50s or 60s. So mentally, or even physically, I could not match that thing. Secondly, Sai had a very different perspective of her own play. It was not the play that I had seen in my head, you know. So I sat down and I spoke to her, and she said, yeah, but we'll work something out. I said, yeah, but for me, theatre is not working something out. It has to be bang on, otherwise it's... See, it can fail later, but at least I have to have the willing suspension of disbelief to get into it, you know. I need to be knowing that this is what I want to do 100%. And after 2 years, I left the play, and then Sai wasn't talking to me for about 3-4 years, till lately, when she forgave me that. And says she also took a much younger actress for that. So I think somewhere what I said made a point with her. And they went on to do a lot of shows. So sometimes, you know, is it the just falling in love with the script that I have read and been with? It shouldn't happen like that. But then Chapakata was a new play. Or the plays that I did with Dehabhan was a completely new play, but the playwright was known to me. So I think for theatre, it has to be complete surrender for me. If I cannot surrender into the script, I don't know whether I want to do it. And as I said, I apply it every day when I go and do my Yeh Hai Mohabbatein Mrs. Iyer. Every single day, I pay attention to my pitch and my sur and where I'm looking, what I'm doing, and that's theatre for me. And sometimes the, you know, in television, the situations that come to you are so ridiculous that I think I'm doing absurd theatre that day, but it's Mrs. Iyer, the character, who's doing it. So she can go anywhere. Who has given me this? Theatre has given me this. That I know Mrs. Iyer, the character, so well that you can put her anywhere today. You put her under hot water, she'll be Mrs. Iyer and she'll come out that way. So, you know, I just feel that what this space, this little space over here has given me, and every time an offer comes to me, I want to chuck everything else and go into it. I think that excitement of theatre should by itself remove the shrinkage that has happened in my head or in my mind. And since I've had an opportunity to open my heart to you and speak, in fact, when Yasha called me up, I said, I don't know what I'm going to say. I'm not active in theatre anymore. But yes, I think I am active because I do go and watch a lot of theatre. I do go and enjoy spaces, just going and sitting in Prithvi or just going to Shivaji Mandir and meeting somebody. I do that. So, you know, that lagav never goes. It's always there. So I thought I could. And he said, speak from your heart. So I have done that. And as I said, I really don't think there's anything wrong with what is happening in theatre today. I don't think. I can't say in hard times. No, you can't say. Okay, probably the youngsters don't have the gurus who are available to us very freely. But then as Milind said, they could go to schools. I haven't, so I'm an unpad actress, you know, in that sense. So they can, if they want to, or they can learn hands-on. Like I did. I've learned hands-on and it's been a wonderful experience, honestly. Because, you know, learning on the job is something which is so tremendously creative. Every day you're discovering a new aspect about yourself. You're failing miserably, you're overacting, you're underacting, you can't remember, whatever it is. But you learn on the job. So I think the only thing perhaps that they don't have somebody to look up to, like we had so easily, they were so easily available. There was Sonta Kesar, there was Alkazi, whose stories we'd heard about from Vijaya Mehta. There were people who we could blindly follow. When Vijaya Bhai said, Nini, tu jaisa natak hai ga, I don't ask her, you know, ka hai bhai, maza role ka hai? No. So I guess we too miss that today, and the youngsters don't have those, but then they find their way, and that's what it is. It's eventually self-discovery. It's I can quote actually a little bit. Well, someone said that theatre is the biggest lie that takes us closest to the truth. So I think I like living this lie and I will continue living this lie even though I may not be in this particular space for the longest time. Thank you.
Thank you, Neenaji. Neenaji took us on a long, long drive right from her younger days. Which she is still young. और उन्होंने एक शब्द का प्रयोग किया कि मैं मज़े लेने के लिए थिएटर करती थी लेकिन मज़े लेने के लिए वो माहौल होना she was fortunate to have around that time. Neena ji was really fortunate to have gurus like Satyadev Dubey. I'm sorry we claim Mr. Alkazi with his institutional background was one of the greatest teacher. बट सत्यदेव दुबे जैसे कि वो अपने आप को सॉरी आवारा कहता था वो थिएटर का आवारा अपने आप से इतना परेशान और इतना असंतुष्ट रहता था और उस असंतुष्टता का हिस्सा वो अपने साथ आने वाले सभी यंगस्टर्स को करवा लेता था दे वर रियली फॉर्चुनेट नीना जी हु हैड द कंपनी ऑफ सत्यजीत सत्यदेव दुबे, दुबे का थिएटर उस जमीन को शायद ही मतलब छूता था, वो हमेशा मतलब हराइजन पे पहुंचता था और वो पहुंच जो है उसके मार्ग अलाइदा होते थे, वो मार्ग हर नाटक के साथ हर प्रोजेक्ट के साथ अलग बनते थे। वो मस्ती में कहते थे और जो शब्द कहना नहीं चाहिए था, लेकिन एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय और राष्ट्रीय सेमिनार में उन्होंने पृथ्वीराज कपूर, हमारे शंभुदा हबीब तनवीर इनके सामने कहा था, मैं थिएटर करता हूँ क्योंकि मुझे थिएटर करने की खुजली है। ये खुजली होना मुझे लगता है ये छोटी बात नहीं है, और वो खुद को होना यहाँ तक ठीक है, लेकिन अपने सभी साथियों तक वो पहुँचा देना मुझे लगता है ये अचीवमेंट की बात है। देन शी हैड बाई हु इज़ मोर देन मदर टू हर, आई नो, आई मीन शी वॉज ग्रेट हैविंग ए रोल ऑफ पेरेंट्स ऑलमोस्ट टू दिलीप एंड नीना जी। लेकिन बाई का एक है कि वो मातृ छाया हुआ करती थी, आप नाटक नहीं सीखते थे, आप जीना सीखते थे उनके साथ, एंड शी वॉज फॉर्चुनेट टू हैव ग्रेट प्ले राइट्स एंड प्लेज विद हर वेर इन नीना जी हैज पार्टिसिपेटेड। हमीदा बाई जी कोठी और छापा काटा, ये दो नाटक जिंदगी में एक्ट्रेस कर ले तो मुझे लगता है कि वो सर्वस्व प्राप्त कर चुके हैं, एंड शी वॉज फॉर्चुनेट टू गो थ्रू दैट एक्सपीरियंस। थैंक यू वेरी मच दोस्तों। उन्होंने बताया कि मतलब समस्या बाहर नहीं है, कोई मेरा थिएटर सिकुड़ नहीं रहा है, यदि कोई प्रॉब्लम है तो यहाँ है, उसे खोलने की ज़रूरत है, और वो खोलने की ज़रूरत इतिहास में हमेशा से रही है। अब मैं थोड़ा सा, मैंने इसके लिए कोई बहुत ज़्यादा तैयारी नहीं की, जिसकी मुझे ज़रूरत भी नहीं थी, क्योंकि मेरे साथ ये जो मेरे संरक्षक है, इन्होंने विषय का विस्तार बहुत अच्छी तरह से किया है दोस्तों। लेकिन मैं सवाल पूछने की क्षमता तब मेरे पास आई जब मैं दिल्ली में राष्ट्रीय नाट्य विद्यालय में छात्र करके चुना गया। उस समय अब आई वॉज जस्ट अ रॉ पर्सन, ही इज़ फ्रॉम अहमदनगर, आई एम क्लोजली फ्रॉम औरंगाबाद। रॉनेस हमारा दोनों का धर्म वही है, हमारी मतलब राशि भी वही है, और हमारा बेतुकापन होना भी वही है। वो आज बहुत संभल के बोले, क्यों पता नहीं मुझे तो मुझे जो मंच के हद तक देखने को दिल्ली में मिला, अपार्ट फ्रॉम नेशनल स्कूल ऑफ ड्रामा, आई वॉज फॉर्चुनेट टू विटनेस द प्लेज ऑफ शंभु मित्रा, उत्पल दत्त, हबीब तनवीर, इन एडिशन टू नेशनल स्कूल ऑफ ड्रामा। आई एम डिलिबरेटली एंड कॉन्शियसली यूजिंग दीज नेम, सम ऑफ यू माइट हैव हर्ड, सम ऑफ यू हैव सीन हिज वर्क्स ऑफ दीज पीपल। फ्रेंड्स, ऑल ऑफ देम वेर पार्ट ऑफ इप्टा, इंडियन पीपल्स थिएटर, एंड इट वॉज मोर अ सोशल मूवमेंट rather than a theater movement. Social movement, because we were most of these people were freedom struggle movement people. they came to theater with a passion to change the society, to change the society and understand your own self, your own existence, your own life. और इस मिशन पे निकले हुए ये लोग थे, लेकिन इनके मार्ग भिन्न थे। शंभुदा बिलोंग्स टू द क्लासिकल मोड ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन, इसलिए उनके नाटक जो थे, अधिकतर नाटक, मोस्ट ऑफ हिज प्लेज, दे वेर रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर प्लेज, पोएटिक प्लेज विद अ डिफरेंट स्टाइल ऑफ एक्टिंग। देन ही अडेप्टेड सम ऑफ इब्सेंस प्लेज ऑल्सो and other modern plays also, but basically he was a classicist. He did Oedipus Rex also, and I can't forget. Oedipus Rex, done by Shambhuda, I can quote and rate that it was far, far different than some of the Peter O'Toole and Paul Scofield and Alec Guinness also. It was one of the finest. Even Girish did that role, but Shambhuda's performance, Om Shivpuri did at National School of Drama, because he has a searching mind of an Indian. It was not from Greek point of view or Western's point of view. That search was from Indian's point of view. And there are several connotations to be an Indian to approach. Utpal Dutt was a movement man, a leftist person. He adapted most of the Russian plays for his theater. But his way of expression was Jatra. He was inspired by Jatra, the local folk performing arts form. And that's why he had music, he has strong lighting, great scenic background. On one hand, he has all these modern adaptations of theater, which were close to film at that time, as it was claimed. Moreover, he was blessed to have some of the best actors of Bengali theater doing small little roles, as we can claim of Broadway or West End. Then Habibda, which is claimed that he was close to Nach, he was close to Macha, I don't believe in it. He was close to himself only. He was again a RADA student for a few years. He came back. But he wanted to have the theater of his own idiom, of his own language. He selected not only the urban actors, but he selected folk artists from Raipur area, who were the folk form performers, and they gave additional color and additional dimension to his theater productions. He did classical Sanskrit plays also, Mitti Ka Gada, Mudra Rakshasa. I assisted him in sets and lighting in Delhi. Those were his productions. Friends, believe me, these three giants doing theater in their time, or they were contemporaries, they had different ways of expression, and still they had the audience which loved them throughout the country. Mr. Al-Kazi's theater was different theater. His was educational institutes theater. He was not bound by any political or social ideology, but being a teacher, he was true to all forms, which we were fortunate to have learned under him, both in production direction classes and on the stage also. Now, when we compare our situation today, कौन है ऐसा कि जो हमारे थिएटर को मतलब दबोच रहा है? कौन सी शक्ति है? मुझे लगता है वो शक्ति ना तो राइटर है, ना तो डायरेक्टर है, ना एक्टर है, ना जो एक और पक्ष है, दर्शक है. मुझे लगता है कि यदि कोई दबा रहा है, या यदि कोई आक्रमण कर रहा है, या जिसका हमें भय लगता है कि हम आक्रमित हो रहे हैं, ये भय है, ये संशय है, वास्तव नहीं है. वास्तव ये है कि हम एक दूसरे से टूट चुके हैं. आई एम सॉरी, द वे वी यूज टू एक्सचेंज. उत्पल बादल सरकार का एक नाटक आता था तो 6 महीने के अंदर उसके कलकत्ता में प्रदर्शन हो रहे हैं, बम्बई में प्रदर्शन हो रहे हैं, बेंगलोर में प्रदर्शन हो रहे हैं. वो आदान प्रदान, द एक्सचेंज, इट इज श्रिंकिंग टूडे, एंड इट इज़ बिकॉज ऑफ दैट प्रॉबेबली वी आर इग्नोरेंट अबाउट ईच अदर्स वर्क. आई थिंक यदि हमें कोई श्रिंक कर रहा है तो ये आदान प्रदान का जो ढर्रा है, ढांचा है, नाइदर वी आर कंसर्न अबाउट इट. आई एम सॉरी टू से, I was very restless. I was sharing with Vaman also yesterday. I was sharing with Bhaiya also, Ashok Bhai. Kitne log manch ke hai ki jo is seminar dekhne, sunne, labhanvit hone ke liye aa rahe hai. It's a national event being organized in your area, in your town. And we are probably, I'm sorry to say, hamari मानसिक दरिद्रता है कि हम उससे कटे रहना चाहते हैं. उसके कारण कुछ भी हो सकते हैं, मतलब कुड बी जस्टिफाइड ऑल्सो, बट ये अलगाव जो है, यदि श्रृंग करने का कोई एक महत्वपूर्ण पक्ष है तो ये पक्ष है. दूसरा अहंकार का पक्ष भी है. हम अपने आप को स्वयंपूर्ण मानते हैं, और वो स्वयंपूर्णता अज्ञान का ही एक मतलब स्तर होता है. when we do amateur theater, we are very happy. If you learn the biographies of great actors all over the country, right from Om Puri to Nasir Bhai to other artists also who are not National School of Drama artists, in their school days, they used to improvise things from the stories, from Ramayans, from Mahabharata, and entertain themselves and entertain even their biradar, jisko keh sakte hain. Wahan gyan nahi hota tha, ek agyan ka star hota hai, usme wo anand lete the. Maharashtra mein amateur theater ki bahut bahut badi matra par matlab natak khele jate hain, hindi pradeshon mein bhi khele jate hain. Amateur theater ke log jo hai, unke जो नाटक है उसके ऊपर उनकी श्रद्धा होती है, उस श्रद्धा के साथ वो एनेक्ट करते हैं, एंड दैट्स व्हाई देयर गुडविल एंड देयर ऑडियंस मेंबर आल्सो कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ दोज पीपल हु आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड व्हाट डिफरेंट स्कूल्स आर देयर इन गुड थिएटर एंड व्हाट फॉर्म्स आर देयर इन थिएटर. दे ओनली एन्जॉय दैट आवर किन्स एंड किड्स आर ट्राइंग टू नरेट अ स्टोरी विच इज नोन टू देम एंड विच इज एनलाइटनिंग मी. ये अज्ञान का है लेकिन श्रद्धा का भाव इसमें है. दैट्स वाई द अमेचर थिएटर इज ऑल्सो सेफ. देन कम्स टू क्रिएटिव थिएटर, एक्सपेरिमेंटल थिएटर. एक्सपेरिमेंटल थिएटर, हु हैज़ द राइट टू डू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स? मेरे अज्ञानवश यदि मैं सोशल प्ले लेता हूँ, कानेटकर का लीजिए या और किसी का ले लीजिए, और उसे यदि काले मतलब पर्दों के साथ और चार मतलब कुर्सियाँ की जगह मतलब चौकियाँ रख के करता हूँ, वो एक्सपेरिमेंटल थिएटर नहीं होता है. एक्सपेरिमेंटल थिएटर, प्रोफेशनल थिएटर, कमर्शियल थिएटर, ये विचारों के साथ होता है. एंड हियर आई एम रिमाइंडेड ऑफ सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट स्कूल्स ऑफ थिएटर ट्रेनिंग, थिएटर अप्रोच. पीटर ब्रूक, ही probably is one of the leading torchlights of modern day theater. 90 साल के उम्र में भी he was active. और यहाँ कुछ ज्ञानी लोग बैठे हैं, वो जानते हैं कि रोप वॉक का उनका एक्सरसाइज है. ये रोप वॉक का एक्सरसाइज जिंदगी भर आपको मतलब पूरा पड़े, जैसे कि भरतनाट्यम का प्रशिक्षण या ओडिसी का प्रशिक्षण पड़ता है, उतना ही महत्वपूर्ण ये रोप वॉक का उनका मतलब एक्सरसाइज जो है. और इसके लिए पीटर ओटुल जैसे लोग भी अपने आप को उनके साथ प्रोडक्शन में ढाते थे. 3 months दे वर्कड विद पीपल लाइक पीटर ब्रूक एंड पार्टिसिपेटेड अ प्रोडक्शन और द अदर. बट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे ही कमिट्स टू हिमसेल्फ दैट आई डिड एवरीथिंग. I did मतलब miracle on stage with stage craft and equipments and music and extrovert. But at the end of his life, he was also convinced that ultimately this is all extrovert, this is all external. Ultimately it is the thought content, ultimately it is the human body which communicates and not the its extravaganza. Grotowski also said the same thing. और यू गो टू ब्रेथ. मैं जानबूझकर ये उदाहरण ये आपके सामने रखना चाहता हूँ कि दे डिड देयर थिएटर इन देयर गिवन कॉन्टेक्स्ट. उनकी समाज स्थिति, द सोशल एनवायरनमेंट, द इंटेलेक्चुअल एनवायरनमेंट, चाहे मेयरहोल्ड ले लीजिए. मेयरहोल्ड वॉज प्रॉबेबली द कलीग ऑफ स्टैनिस्लावस के, but he revolted against the Stanislavski system and constructivism mein chale gaye wo. He changed the ideas, and what he suffered, he was banned, he was imprisoned, unko matlab mara gaya, unki patni ko matlab she was murdered literally, aur usi mein, usi ke aghat mein unki bhi matlab unka bhi ant ho gaya. टेररिस्ट करके उनको मतलब ने ऐलान कर दिया गया. एंड आफ्टर हिज डेथ वो 1940 में चले गए. एंड ड्यूरिंग 55 ही वॉज, उनके मतलब दोष आरोप जो है उनके निकाले गए. दोस्तों दे वर रिएक्टिंग टू देयर सोसाइटी. जैसे मैंने बताया इप्टा के समय जो उद्देश्य था इस देश को स्वतंत्र देश को सुराज्य बनाना है, लोगों के ऊपर जो अत्याचार है वो हटाने हैं, लोगों को अपने हक दिलवाने हैं, ये उद्देश्य था. आज के हालात जो है क्षमा करना हमारे आपे के बाहर हो गए हैं. हमें अपना दुश्मन दिखाई नहीं दे रहा है. यदि मैं क्रिटिसाइज करना चाहता हूँ तो किसे क्रिटिसाइज कर सकूँ? ब्रिटिशर्स को हमने क्रिटिसाइज किया एक ज़माने में. आज हमारा शत्रु हमें दिखाई नहीं देता है क्योंकि वो सुप्तावस्था में चहों दिशाओं से हम पे आक्रमण करने के लिए तैयार है. दे आर नॉट ओनली पीपल एट द पावर हेल्म ऑफ द पावर बट दे आर ऑल्सो विद इन योर सेल्फ. मुझे लगता है कि इन स्थितियों को बदलना पड़ेगा. हमें वो दर्शक नहीं मिल रहा है जो हमसे अमेचर नाटक की तरह प्यार करता है. वो दर्शक हमें लाना है, जुटाना है कल के रंगमंच के लिए. आई थिंक वी विल हैव टू इक्विप एज एन एक्टर इन ऑल प्रोबेबल डिसिप्लिन्स. एज द यस्टरडे के वामन जी के मतलब की नोट एड्रेस में था कि आफ्टर 20 ईयर्स वी विल बी रूलिंग द वर्ल्ड थिएटर. यदि वो करना है, इफ़ यू इंटेंड टू हैव दैट एन ऑब्जेक्टिव, देन आई थिंक द इंडियन एक्टर विल हैव टू ट्रेन हिज बॉडी इन द क्लासिकल एंड फोक ऑल्सो स्टाइल. एट द सेम टाइम कल जैसे मैंने गुजराती नाटक में कहा था कि अपनी वाणी पे काम करना एंड टू डू द मैक्सिमम टू ड्रॉ द मैक्सिमम इम्पैक्ट एंड इफेक्ट थ्रू मिनिमम मीन्स. यहाँ प्रदीप राणे शफा जी जैसे लोग बैठे हैं, इनका सार्थ नाटक बिल्कुल ही नगण्य चीज़ों से निर्माण हुआ था क्योंकि उसका विषय उसका आशय बहुत महत्वपूर्ण था. तो मुझे लगता है कि ये जो भय ये जो आतंक है वो हमारे लैक ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन से हैं, अज्ञान से हैं, आउट ऑफ इग्नोरेंस हैं, उसको हम ब्रिज करें आज जैसे नीना ने कहा, तो मुझे लगता है कि ये अचीव करना मुश्किल नहीं होगा. आपने इतने ध्यान से सुन लिया हम चारों को, इसके लिए मैं आपके प्रति आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ. और अगले आदेश क्या है मैं अशोक भाई से पूछूंगा. Shantanu. Thank you, Shantanu.
Thank you so much to all of you for giving such a, sharing your learned experience with us. And thank you all. There is a little lunchbox waiting outside for all of you. We will all gather around in an hour. I think it's 1:30, so we gather around 2:30. And five very bright minds have been observing and seeing, hearing the seminars from yesterday. Suchismita Bhattacharji, Sanyukta Thorat, Manaswini Lataravindra, Lika Klemova, and Jayant Shivtekar. And from 2:30 onwards, we will hear their views, both nationally and internationally, on the seminar and from their perspective as well. And I hope we all see you again at 2:30, and please join us for lunch. Thank you.